Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and my fifth video in continuing to talk about America and its, relation to gun violence, because that is a huge problem in this country. And this is the video where I kind of just want to try to answer this question: how do we solve the ridiculous gun violence rate in America? And that's been the central theme of many debates surrounding this topic. And for the most part, the talk has mainly been about guns. Even with my videos, it has been about guns, how to regulate guns, how to keep gun rights in order to reduce gun violence. But in all honesty, I think the biggest way we can start making change in this issue is not... This issue goes beyond just the issue of guns. We can have the best gun laws in the world, and we can have the best guys with guns fighting the worst guys with guns, and we can have that, the two extremes. And this issue would still be a huge issue, I think. And that's because America, especially, the roots of this issue are historical, are cultural, and societal. And if we don't fix those other things, this will continue on forever. And so one thing about the culture aspect is, I think it's really great that this country values the Second Amendment so high and its individual liberty so high. For example, I like the fact that Japan has a ridiculously low gun violence rate, or gun just death rate. I believe in 2012, it's like 4 people died from guns for that whole year, which is ridiculous. But as someone who values gun rights, I do not want to see what is the case in Japan be the case for America, because they have such strict gun laws. Their police force has pretty much really big authority over people's lives, and the cost of individual freedom for Japan in order to have that ridiculously low gun violence, it's a cost that's way too high. Also, because of their cultural, societal, racial homogeneity, it's mostly Japanese people in Japan, and because of this whole cultural difference in Japan, they have reduced gun violence, but their crime rate is still really high. There's many other societal ills in Japan that's quite embarrassing. Even without guns, Japan has a suicide rate that is one of the highest in the entire world. So that's why, when I start having these comparisons with other countries in America, it's also important to make those distinctions. It's important. And America is it's a totally different country. Even if we start comparing America to a country like Canada, its neighbor, which has a pretty low violence and crime rate, actually, with really strict gun laws, it's still a whole different society altogether with different cultural mindset. And I think that's the most important thing here, is we need to actually start changing the culture. I don't know how much I agree to this, but there is a counter to the conservative saying, or the gun rights people saying, hey, guns don't kill people, people kill people. That's a pretty well-repeated mantra for people, from the gun rights people. And the progressive counter, I guess, is guns don't kill people, gun culture kills people. In some ways, that is a phrase that's a little bit too simplified, but it has a lot of truth to it, in that this society as a whole, because we are so paranoid, we've been made so paranoid, and we're clinging to our guns, we're clinging to our safety nets in our homes, because of this media cycle, because of advertisements, magazines, the stuff we watch on TV, the stuff we read, the stuff we see on the internet, telling us all these things that we should be afraid of. Because of that sense of paranoia, we are really attached to our guns. I think we really need to start lessening that impact. More on that, it is a societal issue. So the fact that people are hungry, and people are unemployed and in poverty, America right now, the recent trend in poverty is pretty pessimistic. More about, just talking about homeless statistics, 1 in 3 homeless are children under the age of 18. And that's risen from like 1990 statistics to where it was like 22% or 19%. It's now close to 33%. So that, the economical state of the country as a whole, as a society, is getting worse. And as that get worse, so does crime. And as crime gets worse, of course gun violence goes up. You know, so we need to start focusing on programs or policies or just culture as overall that comes together and tackles these other issues like poverty, unemployment, homelessness, good education. Education is one thing where many states, especially the conservative red states, the local governments are willing more to invest in prisons than in schools because they kind of given up on the troubled kids. They're going to end up in juvenile detention anyway, so we're going to create more prisons instead of have more funding for schools. These are kind of the issues that, while separate issues, they do tie into the gun violence issues. And I think working on those issues will make an even much bigger impact on gun violence as a whole than focusing on what is the right gun law to have. Gun legislation, if perfected, would be great. But at the same time, the impact they would make to this overall picture of how do we solve the gun violence issue is very small compared to fixing or ameliorating these other social and cultural issues that are at play here. And I think that's really crucial to solving the gun violence issue. So everything, as I always believe, is a lot of issues are always tied in together. And we need to really just start tackling on that, especially because in a country like America, the ties, the sentiment that gun rights people have to their guns, it's so strong that perhaps going about the way of, you know, trying to create new legislation regarding guns is not the right way to go, because it totally offends this base of people who are all about gun rights, and that does include liberals as well and Democrats. There are a lot of liberal Democrats who are fiercely adamant about their gun rights, and you are offending them by creating new legislation that would regulate and control those guns. I personally am in favor of some measure of gun control, but at the same time, because I believe we need them to be federal in order to make a meaningful impact, having gun laws is dangerous in this country. I wish it wasn't dangerous, but that's the nature of it. And so I feel like our focus should be really on fixing the country's other societal and cultural ills.